All right, folks, we are going to find out what the best weapon in RimWorld is, and we're going to find that out for every situation and every type of enemy. And we are going to do that without looking at all the stats, without doing a load of thinking. We're going to run a load of experiments and just find out what is the best weapon. So today we are going to cover all of the big hitters. We've got LMGs, SMGs, chain shotguns, assault rifles, sniper rifles, and the big old minigun. And for those of you who haven't seen any of the previous videos, the way that we do this is we've set up a firing range, we've got a host of pawns all with 10 in shooting, no particular talents with regards to the shooting, normal weapons, and we are going to test it out on a whole host of unarmored targets, which are immobilized, buffalo. We're going to test it at a host of ranges, short, medium, and long. And we're going to do the same again for armored targets, scythes. And what we're going to do is we measure the time to kill for each of these targets, average them all together, plot them on some graphs. And that way, we don't have to worry about all of the fancy stats, all of your cooldowns, your number of shots per burst, your damages, your penetrations, and boil that all down into simple, easier to understand stats. Okay, so first, unarmored targets. First, with the sniper rifle, you've got a huge range. You've got a huge range on your sniper rifle. But for that range, you are paying for it with a really long time to kill with anything over a long or a medium distance. It really is a huge trade-off for that extra range that you're getting. And this is versus unarmored targets as well. Similarly, at short range, you are taking way longer to kill anything than any of the other weapons that we're hosting here today. Of our remaining weapons that fire over a long range, so these are the dark blue bars, given the spread that we're getting from our results, there's not much to choose between assault rifle and the LMG here with the unarmored targets. However, the minigun does seem to come out slightly on top with a tighter spread and a lower average. And actually, when we get to a sort of a medium range, we see that a lot of these weapons have very similar spreads of results. And again, even the weapons that can't reach, don't have a long enough range to reach that long range, you're not actually seeing too much more benefit with the heavy SMG and the chain shotgun over the LMG and the minigun, especially over a shorter range. And actually over the medium range, the minigun and the LMG are on average coming out on top. And now to look at the short range, we're going to have to zoom in a bit. So this is the same graph, just zoomed in a bit further. And what you'll notice actually is for a couple of them, for the minigun and the LMG, there's no proper box plots because everybody basically just dies at the same time, other than a couple of outliers, which are our dots. So the averages are sort of bang on and the spreads are really tight. And actually over a very short range, the winner is the chain shotgun with its huge amount of burst and really good close quarter damage. However, not far behind it, LMG and minigun are also really doing the business. So prime contenders, when we're just looking at unarmored targets, minigun, LMG, maybe chain shotgun as well. A bit interesting. Next, serious business, armed targets. Here we're using scythers, but this is applicable to all kinds of raiders that are wearing armor. Anything like that. So, armored targets, again, sniper rifle. Even though it's got that pen, you still got a huge trade-off for having that much longer range with doing damage over a significantly longer time period than you have with any of the other weapons. Similar story with the long range weapons again. Minigun perhaps having a much tighter spread, just edging out the LMG this time, and the both edging out the assault rifle. And then that's where things get interesting. So medium range, chain shotgun, king here. Much tighter spread, much shorter time to kill than any of the other weapons over a medium distance. Looks like a strong contender. Best of the rest, minigun. Minigun does well just for the sheer number of bullets. Not got huge penetration, but just brute force. And again, not too much to pick between the LMG, the heavy, the assault rifle. I say that there's actually probably 50 seconds difference between these. LMG still coming out on top. Back with our zoom into short range. Who wins over short range? The minigun murders everything dead in seconds. Not really a surprise. And this time it just topped out the chain shotgun, which was next. Again, LMG a respectable third, but given this data, I wouldn't consider a sniper rifle ever, I don't think. I don't think I'd ever consider an SMG or an assault rifle. And it'd be between these three for my favourites, depending on the situation. And what this data really shows is that penetration isn't necessarily king if you can fire a whole host of shots off. If you keep trying hard enough, you'll get there in the end. And that's what the minigun's all about. End game, minigun is the way forward, but it's a little bit more research to get there. Before then, definitely looking at a chain shotgun or maybe an LMG. And as for sniper rifles, well, unless you've got a guy with like 20 shooting who can actually nail a target from that distance, I wouldn't bother with it. You're going to be whiffing so many times. It's just, it's not worth it. So what do you think to our conclusions, guys? I'd love to hear what your favourites are. And if you'd like to see what my conclusions were on the early game weapons, check out the video here. Otherwise, enjoy your RimWorld, and I'll catch you later.